U.S. embassy flag flown out of Afghanistan amid chaotic evacuation from Kabul airport. U.S. embassy in Kabul closed on Sunday. Fox News has obtained an image of the U.S. embassy flag being flown out of Kabul, Afghanistan. The embassy is in the Afghan capital, closed down on Sunday following reports that officials there were destroying sensitive documents and equipment ahead of the Taliban's arrival. The Taliban now control Kabul and the rest of Afghanistan. Yeah. Thanks, Joe.
Get off the sidelines and into the excitement of sports betting with TwinSpires. New players can get up to
fast-moving developments on Kabul. Perhaps this is the moment so many will remember. This is a U.S. Air Force C-17 at the airport in Kabul from just a few hours ago. Afghans by the thousands desperate to escape life under the Taliban. If that video continues to roll, you see the plane take off, and without showing that to our viewers at home, a few of those who cling on to that wing drop from several thousand feet above the airport in Kabul. I'm Bill Hemmer. Good morning. It's a Monday. Dana, good morning to you.
Good morning.
A moment of history together.
Indeed it is. I'm Dana Perino. This is America's Newsroom, and for the Afghans that were clinging to the plane, I think of two things. One, that the pilot knew what was happening, he had to get out anyway. And the second thing is that they were willing to face a certain death because the alternative to them staying was worse than trying to leave.
So many times the images that you remember for years to come may very, very well be this one that we're showing you right now. And I think if you watch the video overnight in the darkness of the airport and here on the tarmac yet again, when people run like this, it shows the inner fear they have. Mm-hmm. That they're trying to get away from, and that's the reality now in Afghanistan. So here we go, next 2 hours, we'll see what we get with more development.
And that's the image today, but the images today and days to come could be even worse. America's exit from Afghanistan has given way to a complete Taliban takeover. It has prompted thousands of people to flood the airport in Kabul. You can see it there. And they are trying to force their way onto this any departing flight.
So meanwhile, the Taliban has set up shop, literally an office inside the presidential palace. That happened on Sunday. The Afghan president left the country. That happened on Sunday. All this appearing to catch the Biden administration entirely off guard. We have not heard from the president in nearly 6 days. He has no public events scheduled for today.
Well, why would he
Here's
want to
his
talk
national
about
security
it? It's clearly
advisor, Jake
Trump's
Sullivan,
fault.
Said a bit earlier this morning.
The president did not think it was inevitable that the Taliban were going to take control of Afghanistan. He thought the Afghan National Security Forces could step up and fight because we spent 20 years, tens of billions of dollars training them, giving them the best equipment, giving them support of U.S. forces for 20 years.
For the Taliban,
and when push came to shove, they decided not to step up and fight for their country.
We have Team Fox coverage. General Jack Kane is standing by with analysis. Peter Ducey is at the White House. But let's begin with National Security Correspondent Jennifer Griffin reporting live from the Pentagon. And you've been reporting on this story for 20 years.
Dana, there are reports of shots being fired at the Kabul International Airport, tear gas and warning shots to keep people off the runway. It's a real humanitarian crisis right now. We've confirmed that the U.S. military has suspended all the evacuation flights out of Kabul until it can reestablish control of the tarmac, which has been...
But they made sure to fly the flag out of there. You gotta love the fucking irony behind that. Hey, I got an idea. Fuck the flag, get the people out of there.
Flooded by Afghans trying to flee the country. Fox News obtained this image of the U.S. embassy flag being flown out of Afghanistan. There are videos, as you mentioned, of Afghans swarming U.S. C-17 transport planes and one man climbing into the fuselage and falling to his death along with others clinging to the wheels of these military aircraft. They sum up the chaos at the airport. Commercial aircraft halted all flights into Kabul this weekend. These are the scenes reminiscent of the U.S. humiliation exit from Vietnam that the administration hoped to avoid.
This is not Saigon. We went to Afghanistan 20 years ago with one mission, and that mission was to deal with the folks who attacked us on 9/11, and we have succeeded in that mission.
No, we have not succeeded in that mission, because guess what? The folks that attacked us, they happen to all be Saudi Arabian. But of course, we go and attack Iraq, and we go and attack our fucking Afghanistan, and then suck the king's dick over there in Saudi Arabia. You know what? Fuck all you sons of bitches in the government. Every last one of you are the fucking problem.
The Taliban essentially took the entire country in just 10 days. The fall of Kabul shocked even the most skeptical military planners. In a rather stunning about-face, President Biden, who has remained holed up at...
What kind of incompetent fools we got running the U.S. military, besides Joe Biden? I think a whole lot of motherfucking generals need to resign immediately because you're all fucking worthless.
Camp David, avoiding any public questioning from the media, approved plans to send 1,000 more paratroopers from the 82nd Airborne to Kabul to evacuate Americans and those who worked with the U.S. government desperate to escape the country. 6,000 U.S. troops will now be on the ground, twice the number of troops that were in Afghanistan when Biden ordered them out in April. Last week, the military said Kabul could fall in 90 days or as little as 30. It fell in just six. My colleague, Jackie Heinrich, broke the news late last night that the Biden administration plans to evacuate 30,000 Afghans, bringing them to Fort Bliss in Texas and Fort McCoy in Minnesota. She obtained the documents with the planning order. Sunday, the head of U.S. forces in the Middle East.
My question is, are you actually evacuating Afghan people that need to be evacuated? Or are you guys evacuating motherfucking terrorists over here? Because you know what? When it comes to the U.S. government right now, I don't trust a goddamn thing you're doing. I don't trust anything you say. I don't trust anything you show me. And there ain't nothing you can do to change that.
General Frank McKenzie met with Taliban leaders in Doha, Qatar, to make it clear that any attacks on Americans would result in a swift and deadly U.S. response. We are now learning President Biden plans to address the nation soon about the developing situation in Afghanistan. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Jennifer. We appreciate it.
Jennifer, thank you.
Unbelievable. Something's got to give. The Joint Chiefs of Staff all need to resign. Every military leader that's in a power position that's been over there in Afghanistan, you all need to resign too, because you're all incompetent fools.